Hello everyone, our today's topic is solvent extraction of oils. So first of all we focus on solvent. Solvent is any material in which solutes get dissolved to form any solution. Solvent is in the form of maximum amount always be used, and solute is in minimum amount, and the product is known as our solution. Our day-to-day common solvent is water. Water is commonly used in our day-to-day life. Water is very good solvent. So basically, when we classify the solvents, it is classified in three types. First one is halogenated. First one is hydrocarbon solvent. Second one is oxygenated solvents. And third one is halogenated solvents. Hydrocarbon solvents are basically aliphatics and aromatics in nature, and oxygenated solvents are mainly just like esters, ethers, glycol. It also contains alcohols, aldehydes, ketones, n number of solvents are there. And halogenated solvents are basically brominated and chlorinated hydrocarbon solvents. So our topic is not to focus on the what is solvent, and we don't want to our main topic is not a solvent, but our topic is actually extraction. The solvent is already everyone of you are aware about what is solvent. Solute plus solvent gives us solution. It is in maximum quantity and this is in minimum quantity. Most of the time it is in solid form, it is in liquid form. Most of the times. So this is all about the classification of solvent. Specifically, when we focus on solvent extraction of oils, then mainly we are dealing with hydrocarbon solvents. Okay, now next one is extraction. So it is all about solvent. Next one is extraction. So basically, when we talk about a complete solvent extraction process, then there are two types of extraction are there. First one is liquid extraction, and a second one is solid liquid extraction. Basically, liquid extraction and solid liquid extraction. So solvent extraction is a process, when we define it in a easier way, or a way we can easily understand. Solvent extraction is a process in which if there is already a mixture of two liquids, just take example, this is the beaker, we already have a mixture of two liquids. A mixture of A plus B, mixture of two liquids, also a mixture of 3, 4 or n number of liquids are there, but basically we just focus a binary mixture, a mixture of two liquids which is difficult to separate with the help of distillation mainly, or various separation processes due to no variation in boiling point is almost same. There is a slight variation in boiling point, and at the same time we are adding a third component. This is first, second, we are adding a third component C, which is our solvent. We are adding a third component to the mixture of A plus B, and this third component is get soluble in one of the two components, and we can easily separate. We may get, there is a probability of we getting the a plus c or b plus c. There is a chances of a plus c we are getting, or a mixture of b plus c, and it will be more easier to separate these solutions, but it is difficult to separate a plus b mixture. So in these cases, in this type of mixture, we can easily be separated out with the help of solvent extraction. So solvent extraction is a process in which a binary mixture is there. If we just consider a binary mixture is there and we are adding the third component into them, and it's difficult to separate this binary mixture. So that's why a third component comes in contact with them, and any one of component of the mixture gets soluble into the our solvent, and easily it will be separated by further processing. This is generally known as liquid-liquid extraction. If these two is liquid, then and we're treating with it with a liquid solvent, it comes under liquid-liquid extraction. If this mixture is of solid liquid and we are treating with it a liquid solvent, then it is known as solid-liquid extraction. There are n number of extractions are there. Basically, today we focus on this solid-liquid extraction, because extraction, basically solvent extraction, is a concept of chemical engineering, and there is no need to focus on solvent extraction. We are mainly dealing with solid-liquid extraction because this is our oil shed. It contains some oil. This is oil, and oil seed is in the form of solid. So we can add some solvent C, deal with this seed, and it can extract this oil outside, that we are getting solvent plus oil. So this type of extraction is known as solid liquid extraction. Extraction of gold from its stone or from its ore is also comes under the solid liquid extraction. Extraction of gold. Gold is in the form of initially when we extract it is just like a semi-solid or in form of liquid. And the solid liquid extraction is also known as leaching process. I think this is more than enough to understand liquid-liquid extraction and solid-liquid extraction. Now, when we're talking about the extraction of oil seeds, extraction of oil from oil seeds, that is solvent extraction of oil, first point is, when the oil content in seed is below 20%, then we go for solvent extraction. Secondly, if naturally few seeds are there, just like soybean seed, oil content is below 20%. So directly we can go for solvent extraction rather than initially go for mechanical extraction. In case, just take example of groundnut oil, then the initial percent oil content is around 40-45%. So go for mechanical extraction. After mechanical extraction, the oil cake should contain oil is in the range of around 5-10%. So if you want to recover this rest oil or remaining oil in the oil cake, then we go for solvent extraction again. And after solvent extraction, around approximate only 0% of oil will left into the oil cake, means around 99 to 99.99% of oil is recovered, means almost with the help of solvent extraction, approximate 100% of extraction of oil is possible. Okay, that's why solvent extraction is important. Solvent extraction process is more efficient. Okay, then need to drop this first. Okay, next thing is about solvent extraction of oil. Next point is, in our ancient time or in old technologies, during old technology, solvent extraction is not used for edible oil processing. Not useful for edible oil processing. It is only used to process non-edible oils. Only used to process non-edible oils, because during processing of oil with solvent extraction process, some traceable amounts or in terms of ppm level of solvent is still left into our oil, which is not good for our human consumption. So in ancient time, solvent extraction is the process only used to treat the non-edible oils. At the same time, with the help of solvent extraction, we are able to extract maximum amount of oil. Just take example of 99% of oil is extracted, or 99.99% of oil is extracted. Very less oil is left, 1 to 0.1% left into the oil cake. So this type of oil cake is highly useful to utilize in the fertilizers. Due to less oil content, they are easily decomposable. Okay. I think this is all about the basic information. One more thing is there. The strong specific characteristics of edible oil from mechanical extraction. It contains odor, taste. When we send the same oil cake for solvent extraction, we lose it. There is a change in odor and taste of oil. So this is the drawback of solvent extraction process. The taste and odor is altered. Okay. Next thing is, in our earlier videos we covered basically pre-treatment of oil sheets and mechanical expression of oil. Now we are focusing on solvent extraction. This is completely different topics. Solvent extraction. So solvent extraction mainly carried out by two ways. Solvent extraction process is carried out. First one is solution extraction. Second one is diffusion extraction. Solution extraction and diffusion extraction. Solution extraction is followed, or solvent extraction of oil sheet carried out by solution extraction when the pre-treatment of oil sheet is properly carried out, and oil cells are readily available into the oil sheet to get exploded and to get expelled out of the oil sheet. Oil is easily expelled out. That is known as solution extraction and diffusion extraction. If in case your pre-treatment of oil sheet is not properly carried out, indicated by red ink, not properly carried out, this is properly carried out. So the oil cells are still intact in nature, and it's really difficult to bring these oil cells readily available for expelling. So this diffusion extraction is a time consuming and a slow process, and a minimum amount of oil is extracted. By diffusion extraction. We will again come to this topic in detail. This is just an overview about solution extraction and diffusion extractions. Only by these two concepts or phenomena, with the help of these two concepts, the extraction of solvent extraction of oil seeds are carried out. Solvent extraction of oil from oil seeds is carried out. Now we will move on the next topic, that is solvent extraction, the factors affecting solvent extraction process. Since solvent extraction process is widely applicable in our edible oil industries for extraction of oils and fats, so what are the factors which affect the solvent extraction process? First one is, there are basically four factors. First one is rate of extraction, or we can say that extraction time. Second one is quantity of solvent used. How much quantity of solvent used to carry out the solvent extraction of oil? First one is extraction time. How much time is consumed by that solvent to extract the oil from our oil seed? Third factor is temperature of solvent. What is the temperature of solvent when the solvent undergoes the solvent extraction process? And fourth factor is very important factor. All four factors are important. Fourth factor is nature of solvent. So one by one in detail we will go through the each factor and just look at how these all factors affects our process of solvent extraction. Before that, in every factor few experiments were carried out, and with the help of these experiments we have a lot many data with us, which is highly useful to just get concluded how these factors affects our process. And the data is on the basis of it sets few factors as a constant, just in extraction time. So extraction time is variable. Rest of the 3-4 factors is constant. Then quantity of solvent. So quantity of solvent used in ml something or liter is fixed. Quantity is fixed. Rest of the factors is variable. This is fixed parameters. In temperature of solvent, temperature is variable. Rest of the factors are constant. Really sorry about it. In extraction time, we focus just on the variable factors. Time is variable. Quantity of solvent used, quantity is variable. Temperature of solvent, temperature of system is variable. And nature of solvent. Nature of solvent there are, and number of factors are there. We'll go one by one. And these types of experiments are basically carried out on four different sheets. just like soybean, groundnut, rapeseed, and one more seed is there, that is sunflower. So instead of concluding any statement with the help of studying or carried out experiments only with the help of only on the single seed, they carried the same experiments on different types of seeds like soybean, groundnut, sunflower, and rapeseed. So first thing is our extraction time. First factor is our extraction time. Before that, I want to draw one table, a small table. Oil seeds, here is soybean, this is groundnut, third one is sunflower, and fourth one is rapeseed. Okay. So experiments were carried out to study the effect of extraction time on efficiency of extraction and quantity of just one factor is calculated. What is the effect of extraction time on the efficiency of extraction, and keep the two other parameters like temperature and weight of the seeds constant. So constant parameters are temperature and weight of seeds. So I want to write these parameters here. There are n number of parameters. First one is temperature, weight of seeds is constant. So temperature is fixed in this process. It is not given here. Time is variable, and weight of seed is fixed, that is 100 grams. So this first experiment is carried out to find out what is the change, or how extraction time affects the efficiency of extraction process, and at the same time temperature and weight of the seed is constant, is shown here. Okay. So the data is obtained like, first of all, the oil percentage, then the amount of oil remaining after wearing time. Wearing time means, first column is for 30 minutes, next column is for 60 minutes, and the last is for 120 minutes. This is in minutes, and oil remaining in percentage. Okay. So initial oil percentage is 19.69. Second one is 12.60. Third one is 11.90. And fourth one is 14.55. See, the percentage of oil content in oil seeds, all are below 20%. So we are easily say that we can select the solvent extraction process to extract the oil from these seeds. Now, after 30 minutes, the temperature is constant, and weight of seeds are 100 grams, and we just add the solvent and go for the solvent extraction process. So after 30 minutes, oil left into the seed is 1.27% of soybean, then 1.07 in groundnut, then 1.40 in sunflower, and 2.65 in rapeseed. Similarly, if we wait for next 30 minutes, then after 60 minutes, 0.96, 0.48, 0.96 for soybean, 0.48 for groundnut, then 0.74 for sunflower, and 0.36 for rapeseed. So when we calculate the extraction time gap, that is from 30 to 60 minutes, more addition of 30 minutes, there is no as such much difference in the percentage of oil left. Okay, after 30 minutes. Then next one is 120 minutes. It is around 0.35 of soybean, 0.26, 0.42, 0.26 for groundnut, 0.42 for sunflower, and 0.72 for rapeseed. 0.72 for rapeseed, and here is one correction, small correction. It is 1.36, not 0.36. Okay. You just observe the table. Observe the table of four different oils. We can easily conclude that just take example of soybean. First of all, there are four different oils, soybean. So first 30 minutes only 1.27% of oil is left into the oil cake, then next 30 minutes 0.96, means there is not that much amount of difference, around only 0.3 is the difference. Then 120 minutes, again we double the time, again we add the 60 minutes, on again 0.35% of oil is left. So when we calculate 1.27 and 0.35, this, there is no such difference like this. So this much amount of losses is acceptable with respect to time. The time which just spent to carry out the process, this type of losses is acceptable. But instead of wasting this amount of time, it is not acceptable here. So first 30 minutes, we can conclude from this experiment. There are four conclusions on this experiment. Okay, wait. There are four different conclusions are there. First one is, extraction time is the fundamental property to carry out any extraction of oil from any oil shed, is the fundamental property. Extraction time is very important property. Then second one is, maximum amount of oil is extracted in first 30 minutes. First 30 minutes means from 19.69, if you minus that 1.27, approximately, forget about this 0.27, 0.6, 18%, around 18% of oil is extracted within first 30 minutes of time. Second one is, third conclusion is, more amount of time is required to extract oil when it below 1%. It's really challenging and difficult. See, 1.07 is remaining, we again add 30 minutes, only 4.8 is remaining. We again add 60 minutes, only 0.26 is remaining. So time consumption is more and oil extraction is less. Quantity of oil extracted is very less with compared with the time. So when the oil content in the oil cake or oil seed is below 1%, then it's really difficult to extract it from the seed. And the fourth conclusion is, every type of seed behaves in a different manner. Every type of seed behaves in a different manner. Okay. See, soybean, groundnut, sunflower, rapeseed, all these four data are different. Oil content is different, solvent is same, contact time is same, extraction time is same, but the quantity of oil extracted is different at different time. Okay, this is about the first factor, how extraction time is important in our solvent extraction process or how it can affect our process. Let's move on the next topic, next factor. Our second factor is quantity of solvent. Second factor is quantity of solvent used to carry out solvent extraction of oil. Again, few experiments were carried out and to study the quantity effect of quantity of solvent used and on the extraction process. At the same time, time and temperature is constant. Here, time 1 more constant is there, time is constant, that is 60 minutes. Temperature is again constant, no issue. Then same type of study is carried out, just like the last factor, soybean, groundnut, rapeseed, sunflower. Time is constant at that time and we just vary the quantity of solvent used. Say we can use 900 ml, 1000 ml, 1200 ml, these type of quantity vary. And again the same factor is calculate how much amount of oil is left in our oil cake, how much amount of percentage of oil is left in our oil cake. So again different values we obtain. So from that experiment we can conclude that we get two conclusions. First of all, we can easily conclude that with the help of constant keeping few parameters like constant temperature and extraction time, the efficiency of extraction is firstly efficiency of extraction is increases when get contacted with when oilseed get contacted with fresh solvent, but after reaching a certain limit there is no noticeable change in rate of extraction. Means similarly, focus on the last factor, that is extraction time. So initially when solvent is fresh and maximum amount of oil is present in our oil seed and they get contacted with each other, so maximum amount of oil is extracted with minimum amount of time, and at that time rate of extraction is very high. Within very less time we can extract maximum amount of oil, but after reaching a certain limit, just take an example of it can reach the limit of 98%. 98% of oil is extracted, then there is no such noticeable change in rate of extraction. The rate of extraction is just like constant or drop down or very slow. Now the next conclusion is, if we want to set a minimum limit of residual oil in cake, minimum limit, just we can say that it is 0.5%. Means 0.5% of oil is still left into the oil cake and we are ready to accept it, or we are ready to accept this loss of oil, 0.5% in our oil cake. So every different type of seed shows different results, or it is totally depend upon the nature of seed. So extract this much amount of oil, which is our minimum limit, we can say that 0.5% of oil is okay to go with oil cake. And in case if you want to extract this minimum residual amount of oil, then according to the nature of seed, it will take its own time and own quantity of solvent is required to extract this much amount of oil. Okay. This is concluded by the quantity of solvent used. So quantity is also plays an important role. Next factor, let's move towards the next factor. Thank you. third factor is our solvent temperature or temperature of solvent during extraction process. So quantity of seed is fixed. Just a minute. Quantity of seed is fixed, 100 grams. Second one is time is fixed. Here time is more. 2 hours. 2 hours is the time. Then next one is quantity of solvent used is fixed. Quantity of solvent used. It is somewhat 2790 ml. This is the experimental value. The quantities on which these all experiments are carried out and to get a certain specific standard results and conclude. So 2790 ml quantity of solvent is used and temperature is variable. Temperature is variable just like 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay. So variable is temperature. Temperature is variable, 20, 30, 40, 50. Weight of oil seeds fixed, 100 grams. Next, time, 2 hours, it is also fixed. Then, quantity of solvent used, 2790 ml, it is also fixed. To find out how solvent temperature affects our solvent extraction of oil. So, again, the same type of experiments are carried out with fixed seeds, soybean, groundnut, rapeseed, and sunflower. Groundnut, rapeseed and sunflower. With all these constant parameters, only the varying parameter is temperature. Temperature is vary from 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 50 degree Celsius. And we can easily conclude that, only one conclusion is obtained, we can easily conclude that rate of extraction is increased with increased in temperature of solvent. But at the same time, this is the most important factor. If we keep going increase the temperature from 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, rate of extraction of oil from oil seed is increased. But at the same time, there is one drawback of this temperature elevation. The drawback is it degrade the oil quality. How can it degrade the oil quality? I will explain when we go through the flow sheet. Right now, just remember that if there is a high temperature elevation, then it can degrade the quality of your oil, which is never adjustable. Okay. The next factor, next and last factor is nature of solvent. So in nature of solvent, temperature is also fixed. All the four parameters are fixed now. Just assume that 50 degrees Celsius. These all are fixed. So what is variable? Our last factor is nature of solvent. If all factors are fixed, then what is variable? Variable is solvent is actually a variable. Here, first we can say that hexane or benzene is used. Second, carbon tetrachloride is used. Sorry, not a carbon tetrachloride. Carbon disulfide is used. Then triethanol, just a minute, trichloroethylene is used, trichloroethylene is used, fourth one is petroleum ether is used, Fifth one is acetone or methanol is used. Sixth one is dichloroethylene, I think. Yes, dichloroethylene is used. So this is the actual variable to study the nature of solvent factor, how it affect the extraction process, solvent extraction process of our oil. So same experiment is carried out, all the parameters are fixed, your temperature, quantity of oil shed, quantity of solvent required, time, each and everything is fixed. Just every time your solvent is different to find out what happened with the different seeds like soybean, groundnut, rapeseed and sunflower. These four types of seeds, what actually happened when we just changing the solvents. Okay, so there are n number of different conclusions with the help of nature of solvents. When we consider nature of solvents, conclusions are more. First conclusion is first conclusion is there are n number of different conclusions obtained after the experiments. First one is hexane and benzene provides same efficiency or same rate of extraction. Then carbon disulfide is more efficient than hexane and benzene, but trichloroethylene is more efficient than carbon disulfide. Okay, these are the different factors which affects the solvent extraction of oil. So we never use any type of any solvent directly. Just if you decided to go for solvent extraction and take any solvent and just select it and proceed with, so it's not that much easier, because the main factor is what? Main factor in solvent extraction is your quantity of oil extracted, from oil seed or oil mill. This is the most important factor. How much amount of oil will be extracted by using any solvent or by using any SOP or any standard procedures or in any step, how much quantity of oil is extracted is the most important factor. Second thing is purity. Okay, we are getting maximum amount of quantity, but purity means quality. Quality, you are getting very dull, then again there is no use of your product. So quality should be your higher. So these two factors, the quantity and quality, is most important factor to select the solvent. Okay, so few insoluble matters are there which are highly soluble in petroleum ether. So petroleum ether is not useful everywhere. So next factor is that, okay, and they have decided that hexane and benzene are traces of hexane and benzene are not that much harmful or acceptable for human consumption. So hexane and benzene is final. And again few points are there beside that conclusion. This is all about the conclusion of your factor, that is nature of solvent. Again there are some factors on nature of solvent is next one is what are the various factors. These factors are basically related to the physical, chemical or actual behavior of your solvent, how it behaves when there is a change in pressure, volume, temperature or any conditions or with some other chemicals, how they behave. This is also very important. So first thing is about hexane or benzene. So benzene and hexane provides latent heat of vaporization is lower latent heat of vaporization of benzene or hexane is lower is compared with carbon disulfide and trichloroethylene. So this is the important one which we required. Second thing, carbon disulfide vapor pressure is very high at 20 degrees Celsius, so boiling point is very less. High vapor pressure and less boiling point. Then trichloroethylene, again vapor pressure is very low, so boiling point is very high. Next is about this, both carbon disulfide and trichloroethylene is corrosive in nature. Next factor is carbon disulfide unnecessarily makes some fumes of sulfur during processing. If you use carbon disulfide as a solvent for your solvent extraction of oil, then at some elevated temperatures it unnecessarily makes some fumes which is difficult to handle during processing. Okay, that is again the drawback of carbon disulfide. Next one is, carbon disulfide is very toxic. Okay, now again few points are till left. Drop this first. This is all about the comparison of various solvents on the basis of their nature. So next factor is, our last factor is, carbon disulfide is toxic in nature. So that's why it is not useful for our solvent extraction of oil, because we are mainly processing with edible oil right now. Then next one factor is, if you talk about the trichloroethylene, then trichloroethylene is only useful where non-inflammable conditions are required. Non-inflammable conditions are required, then only trichloroethylene is used. At the same time, quantity of oil is not a priority. Means you are okay with the less quantity of your yield or less quantity of oil. Next solvent is about petroleum ether. Petroleum ether is used where the boiling point conditions not exceed. Means temperature is important, boiling point temperature, especially in the case of petroleum ether, is useful only to treat essential oils. Means it is a specifically useful petroleum ether. Next is, next one is acetone. Acetone is mainly used to remove gossip oil from cottonseed oil. At the same time, methanol is also useful. So again, a specific use. This is also specific use, and trichloroethylene is also specific use, only useful for non-inflammable conditions, and quantity of oil is not the priority factor. And last one is, dichloroethylene is useful to treat coca butter or to extract coca butter. So this is all about the various solvents which are already studied before going to finalize anything about the solvent extraction, about the temperature at which it is working, about the time of extraction, the quantity of solvent used, and which type of oil you are processing. So these are the all factors which affect your solvent extraction process. So finally, which one is best? hexene or benzene is the best solvent for solvent extraction process. Okay. And mostly hexane is useful or hexane is used for the solvent extraction of oils. Now we will move on the type of extractors. Various types of extractor used is or the extraction processes. So we mainly focus on the continuous extractors. Continuous extractors, there are basically three different plants or three different types of processes. First one is immersion, second one is percolation, and third one is combined immersion and percolation. This is extraction plant, immersion extraction plant, percolation extraction plant, combined immersion and percolation extraction plant. Okay, so one by one we can see. Classified under the continuous extraction. First thing is instead of seeing it individually, we just compare it immersion extraction and percolation extraction. It will be more better for us carried out within few minutes, in next few minutes. First one is okay. So any type of solvent extraction is mostly carried out by these two processes, immersion, percolation, these three processes. Immersion, percolation, or combined immersion and percolation. So first one is immersion. Immersion, from word we can say that an excess amount of solvent is used and seeds are completely immersed into that solvent and the extraction starts. So this is a static type immersion. Static type, there is no movement of solvent is there. There is no movement or very slow movement of solvent is there, because just consider a vessel filled with solvent, and you directly put all the seeds into that vessel. So solvent plus oil seeds is there, and a stationary film. It can form a stationary film around the seeds, and that's why it is in the static type manner. Here the solvent use is maximum. This is about immersion. Now percolation is the process where it is highly useful if your pre-treatment of oil seed is carried out in a proper manner. Then your oil cells are completely exploded more readily and easily, and it will become more easier to extract the oil from your oil seed. So percolation is helpful. Just consider a vertical vessel where all oil seeds are kept, which are already pre-treated in a proper manner. And you just put solvent from top, and it starts flowing with the help of gravity in a downward direction, vertical upward direction. Okay. So a very thin layer of solvent is get contacted with your outer surface of seed. And it readily flow down to the next seed. So it is a rapid flow. The flow of solvent is rapid flow, and a thin layer is formed. Here the quantity required is minimum. Okay. Second factor is, before moving to second factor, talk about anything, immersion process, percolation process, or combined immersion or percolation process. But what actually the phenomena of this extraction is, each and every time the seed which contains higher amount of oil get contacted with the solvent which contain lower amount of oil, means at the same time the seed which contains lower amount of oil, if we can say that some few seeds are mechanically extracted and this oil cake is again sent for the solvent extraction to extract the rest of the oil, then if the seed contains minimum amount of oil, then the solvent will contacted with it, and it also contains initially a minimum amount of oil. So oil seed with minimum amount of oil and solvent with minimum amount of oil is get contacted and get extracted. This is the actual phenomena beyond this concept. Next one is it is more suitable for well-pre-treated seeds. If the seeds are very fine and not that much pre-treated properly and contains less amount of oil, then immersion is a good process, because already the oil present is less, so you need to extract it. Okay, here oil percentage is more. Then the third factor is in immersion, the third factor is about we just covered a few minutes ago the topic, that is a solution extraction and a diffusion extraction. Diffusion extraction means minimum amount of oil is there and the oil cells are intact in nature. So percolation is a diffusion. Percolation is carried out with the help of diffusion extraction, because oil cells are not readily available, oil cells are intact. And immersion process is carried out with the help of diffusion extraction, and percolation process is carried out with the help of solution extraction. This is again the difference between them. Then the next point is quantity of oil extracted, immersion and percolation. Quantity of oil extracted by immersion is max to max 15% of oil is extracted just because of diffusion extraction. 15% is max, and it is around 25 to 35% of oil is extracted, which is also maximum. Then last point is, when you compare both percolation and immersion, last point is in whole processing of our oil, it may be pre-treatment, mechanical extraction, solvent extraction, or after, once you get the crude oil, the stages of refining, there should be a chances that our oil in every stage contains small amounts of solids or fines or impurities, because oil is a mixture of glycerol and fatty acids. Various types of fatty acids are present, and it will behave differently according to the different nature and different conditions. So there is a strong chances that in percolation process the solvent used is less and a contact time is very low, so the fines or impurities are less. And here what actually in immersion means, we directly immerse our seeds into the solvent, so the fines or impurities are more. Next point, there is no next point, only 5 comparisons are there. So immersion and percolation, this is all about immersion and percolation, and a best example of combined immersion and percolation process is our Soxhlet assembly is available in our lab, and it is a good example of immersion and percolation, and with the help of Soxhlet assembly 100% of oil extraction is possible. Means we can say that 99.99% of oil extraction is possible. It is just like an ideal process, Soxhlet assembly. Now we will move on to the next topic, that is type of extractors. There are n number of different extractors used to carry out this extraction. Few are like batch type, few are like semi-continuous, and next one is continuous. So mainly we focus on the continuous type of extractor instead of focusing a batch type or a semi-continuous, which are already obsolete and very old technology, not in use now. So continuous type of extractor. So there are almost 5 to 6 different type of extractor are there. So extractor, first one is Hildebrandt extractor. Second one is Anderson extractor. Third one is Lurgi extractor. Fourth one is Euler extractor. Fifth one is Rotocell extractor. Sixth one is CMB extractor. Solvent extraction of oil actually carried out into the extractor. Rest of the equipments and unit operations are there, definitely no there is no issue, because it's a complete flow sheet. Solvent extraction is a complete flow sheet, but the main operation of extraction is carried out inside the extractor. So these are basically 6 type of extractor. When we classified it accordingly to the accordingly, just like semi-continuous, continuous, or according to the processes which are already classified, just like percolation, immersion, combined percolation and immersion. So if we classified according to these three type of operations, if we classified extractor according to the type of operations, then we are just focusing on this combined percolation and immersion process, because it is highly applicable in industries, combined percolation and immersion process. So in combined immersion and percolation processes, these all 6 expellers are classified, out of which Hildebrandt expeller we will see today. To understand the operation of expeller, rest of the expellers are also working in the same manner, but there is a quite changes in design, in size, in a rate of extraction. There should be a chances that it will vary according to the extractor, but the actual concept and phenomena in which extraction is carried out is same for all the extractors. So let's move on. The first extractor, that is Hildebrandt extractor. It is just like a U-tube, it is just like a U-shaped system,
different extractor.
It is just like a U-shaped extractor. Like this. And get divided into the three rectangles or three different units. This is actually the first unit, this is second, and this is the third one. Get joined with the type of conveyor. Then this is the actual inlet A. This is a type of filter. Then this is the outlet, this is the inlet A, this is the outlet B, here somewhat again, the inlet C, and from here one more outlet E, and this is another outlet D. A is inlet for your oil mill. I will explain instead of writing each and everything. I will explain it. A is the inlet of your oil mill or oil seed. Then B is the outlet of your oil mill. B is the outlet of your oil mill without oil. There is no oil present. Then C is the inlet for solvent. From here, solvent will come. Okay. And D is the outlet for micella, oil plus solvent is micella. D is again the outlet, and E is the outlet for solvent only. I will explain one by one. These are the five different conditions: A, B, C, D, and E, inlet and outlets available in this extractor. This is the extractor which mainly works on the combined process of immersion and percolation, combined immersion and percolation extraction plant. So what actually happens in this operation, our flex or oil sieves come from here. It is the inlet for it, and it will get entered into the extraction, and the direction of flow is like this. It will flow, and it will travel with the help of these conveyors or rotating screws, and at the same time, when we inlet the flex from here, solvent is inserted or solvent is put into your extractor. So solvent is also there, and the contact of solvent plus oil mill is in counter current way. Solvent will travel in the upward downward direction, and flex or oil sheets will travel to the upward vertical direction with the help of these screw fitted channels. And the complete extractor is filled with the oil flex and solvent only. So solvent tried to move in this direction, and flex tries to move in this direction. So this is the actual channel, and it will get a very high specific surface area, contact surface area, due to the time of extraction and rate of extraction is very high, time of extraction is less, and intimate contact between the flex of oil sheets and solvent is occur here. So in this way, solvent will traveling with, once the solvent is get contacted with your oil mill, oil starts extracting into the solvent, and it will start flowing towards opposite direction, and it will meet to this filter type. This is a filter, a specific type of filter is here, and here again oil plus solvent is there, but with the help of some fine solids, some impurities, some solid materials, some extra material is there, which is a foreign particle or impurities are there, which will be filtered here, and from here outlet we are getting oil plus solvent as a micella, mixture of oil plus solvent we are getting here, and then again the oil cake starts moving into the upward direction from here with certain amount of oil, very less amount of oil, and it contains somewhat more amount of solvent is also there, but the oil content is very less, and it will be expelled out or throughout from this outlet. That is oil with a oil mill without oil. Oil percentage is very less, but up to this section the solvent content is high because this is the actual inlet. So at this place heaters or evaporators are provided. So that the oil cake which contains some amount of solvent get evaporated and sent to here. That is the specific outlet for solvent only, in the form of vapors. Solvent in the form of vapors. So it get collected and sent for cooling. Okay, so in this way solvent is recovered from here. So A is used for inlet, B is used for the outlet of cake, C is unit is the inlet of solvent, D is the outlet for micella, and E is again the recovery of solvent is there. In this way Hildebrandt oil expeller is worked, and the specific few points about it is that the Racine times of flex, it is varies around 30 minutes or half hour, and the oil concentration is in the micella. Initially, the oil concentration in the micella, this is also the micella. Micella means mixture, any mixture, oil cake plus oil. So we can say that a micella. Again, this is a micella, but it is oil plus solvent. So here the oil percentage present is around approximate 12%, and it will proceed as a complete combined immersion and percolation process is occurred inside this extractor, and this solvent get contact with this flakes, and a maximum amount of solvent, a maximum amount of oil is extracted. So from this outlet we are getting a different micella, that is oil plus solvent, and the concentration of oil here in this micella is around 25 to 30%. So the concentration is increased when we compared with it solvent. Okay, in this way oil is extracted from this process. Okay, I think I cover each and everything. So let's finally move on our proper process, that is solvent extraction of oil, proper topic with flow sheet. I already covered this extractor, because with flow sheet it's really difficult for me to manage on the board each and everything. So that's why I covered this extractor individually, and now we will focus on the flow sheet. Now I'm actually moving on solvent extraction process. How solvent extraction process is carried out in industry? So first of all we go through the flow sheet. A basic flow sheet is there. This is your extractor E. From extractor you get one product. Same for distillation unit, again you get one product. This is same for micellar refining. Micellar refining carried out with the series of evaporators. Series of evaporators are there. There is one another bypass. If there is no necessity to go for the purity of your crude oil, then you may skip it. Skip this micellar refining, and then your crude oil is ready. So this is our solvent extraction process. So it is obtained from first thing in terms of flex, generally flex from preparation which is already prepared. Flex here, one storage of solvent is here. Solvent storage is here. So we add solvent to our extractor, and from extractor we get two products. First one is our oil plus solvent, that is micella. Oil plus solvent is micella, and a oil cake or a extracted meal. Extracted meal is sent for desolventizing and toasting. In short, right here, desolventizing and toasting. Desolventizing and toasting operation is carried out here. The expelling milk is with its content 25 to 35% of solvent, so it is again separated and sent to distillation column in the form of vapor solvent plus steam. This is actually the mixture which we obtained from the desolventizing and toasting section. Just a minute. Desolventizing and toasting. Okay. Then this distillate here, oil plus solvent will come into the distillate, and solvent, this is actually the distillation unit. Solvent is getting as the top product. So solvent is recovered, sent for the storage, and oil as a bottom product, which is sent for further processing. Okay. From next, desolventizing and toasting. Here the inlet of steam is there. Here steam is used. From desolventizing toasting, it is sent for drying and cooling. And after it is sent for grinding or size reduction. Yes, sizing is here. Sizing, then it is sent for grinding if needed. Again, some part of grinding is recycled to obtain the proper sizing. Then after sizing, it is sent for packing, load out, loading, and then transportation. Transport, load out, this is your storage. Okay, now this is crude oil, and this crude oil is further sent for refining. So DS stands for desolventizing, T stands for toasting, and again D and C stands for drying and cooling. This is the actual flow sheet of your solvent extraction. How solvent extraction is carried out in industry. Most of the less or more in a similar way, similar manner, the solvent extraction is carried out by following these type of flow sheets. Okay, let's move on one by one. A unit operation, various unit operations carried out in this solvent extraction process. So first thing, we are getting the flakes which are already obtained from the which are already prepared, or the seeds which are pre-treated. Flakes in terms of, we are getting the flakes of that seeds like groundnut, which come after mechanical extraction. Means if there is excess amount of oil is present, then initially it is sent for the mechanical extraction, and after mechanical extraction, if it contains approx any 5 to 10% of oil is there, then it is sent for the solvent extraction for further extraction of oil. Or instead we can say that a flakes from prepared flakes of soybean is obtained. Soybean, so already actual percent of soybean is below 20%. Oil content in soybean is below 20%. So pre-treated flakes of soybean is obtained and directly sent for the extractor. Extractor, I just earlier of this topic I explained the Hildebrandt extractor and a complete operation, how it is working and how with the help of solvent we can extract oil. So in this extractor we need an input of solvent. So here solvent is come, solvent flex extraction, solvent extraction is carried out and we are getting two products. One is our main product, another is our byproduct. Two products is, first thing is oil plus solvent. We are getting oil plus solvent, which is further sent for distillation. And the second product, this is our second product, this is our first product. And the second product is extracted meal or white flesh, we can say that, or white meal, we also can say that it is a white flakes of seeds we are obtained from extractor, and it is sent for desolventizing or toasting section. Desolventizing and toasting, this is DS for desolventizing and toasting. I will explain one by one in detail. Once I just roughly cover all the flow sheet, then from desolventizing and toasting it's sent for drying and cooling operation, because the temperature is very high. So drying and cooling, after drying and cooling it sends for sizing. This is all about our oil cake. This is all about your oil cake. So sizing is carried out. Sizing, if more or less sizing is needed, then go for grinding, and some part of grinding is recycled to carry out the operation of sizing in a proper manner. And finally it is get sent to stored, then load out and then transport. Okay. Now the first main product which are obtained is oil plus solvent. This oil plus solvent is sent to distillation column. In distillation, this oil plus solvent gets separated. So due to there is a huge difference between boiling point, so easily with the help of distillation operation, we are able to separate it in different two products, different two components. First thing is oil. Oil is sent for oil, and a very less here it also contain. From distillation we are not getting a purest form of oil, so a very less small amount of solvent is also present here. Just like 99% of oil plus 1% of solvent. Okay, so that's why here refining is necessary. Means micellar refining is there. Okay, because for just this 1% of solvent is there, and this is maximum amount of solvent. Say 99% of solvent plus 1% of oil is here. So this solvent from this distillation column, top of this column, we getting the solvent sent for the it get cooled and sent for the solvent storage, and it is again recycled. At the same time, from bottom of this distillation column we are getting oil plus solvent, and only 1% of solvent is present. Approximately, it just on assumption basis, around 1% of solvent is present and 19% of oil is there. So it goes for a micellar, because micellar is just a mixture. Again, it is a mixture of oil plus solvent. So with the help of refining, a series of evaporators are fitted here, and after every single evaporator we are getting a purest form of oil. So after that actual crude oil, actual pure crude oil we are getting. Or solvent is also present, and a traceable amount of some fines material or solid material is also present, which is also get removed during this series of evaporation operation. So crude oil is getting, we are getting actual purest form of crude oil. Now this crude oil is ready to send for the refining process. This is all about to get the crude oil. Now Next section, from DSDT, what actually happens? Some of quantity of solvent is also present in our oil cake. It is around 25 to 30%. 25 to 30% of solvent is there. So we can pass the steam, and with the help of vapor and steam mixture, again a solvent is get recycled to the distillation column, and recovery of solvent is there. Okay. Now we will go into the deep of this flow sheet. So the most important factor in our extractor is temperature control. There should be a very important factor to control the temperature. Temperature control is very important. In this video earlier, we just focus on various factors which affect the solvent extraction process, in which the temperature of solvent is there one factor, and with the help of increasing temperature, if we goes on increasing from 20, 30, 40, 50, the rate of extraction of oil from solvent keep going increasing. So anyone wants to operate this extraction operation at the highest temperature, but the most important factor is what the operator will set this extractor at its highest temperature. Just take example of 50 degrees Celsius, just assume it the temperature, but at the same time, if we cross this temperature, then the phospholipids, phospholipase enzyme, which are present inside your oil or oil mill, get damage your quality of oil, and at the same time it produced non-hydrated phosphatides. These are the reason behind it. So the operator will operate at its highest point, but the control on temperature is most important parameter. If temperature is goes on increasing, then the quality of oil is completely degraded. We get the minimum quality of oil, and at the same time the gums, which will get separated in refining process, first stage of refining, it is non-hydrated, means less water soluble gums. So this is again a drawback. That is the most important drawback of this extractor. In extractor, flakes are coming as a input or a raw material. Solvent is used to carry out the solvent extraction process. And the extraction is carried out not only in a single stage. There are 2, 3, 4, 5 washes of extractor are given. And after that, a final wash of extractor, solvent is provided to our oil sets or oil mill to extract the rest of the oil, and some retention time is provided, around 30 to 45 minutes. And after that, the oil cake and oil plus solvent is get removed. Then after, from extractor, we are getting the extracted flesh or extracted meal. Which is also known as white flakes of the seeds, and white flakes of the seeds sent for the desolventizing. Why desolventizing is needed here? Because your oil cake, simply we can say that extracted meal or white flakes or oil meal contains 25 to 30% of solvent, means a very a good amount of solvent is present in your oil cake. So there is a necessity to remove it, because this much quantity of solvent is not acceptable for edible purpose. So in desolventizing operation, your solvent is get removed. So in this desolventizing operation, actually a steam is used, and a counter current arrangement is provided to remove the solvent from the solid phase. Then vapor phase is passed through the distillation, and then condensing and collection of the solvent is carried out here. most of the time anhexane is used as the best solvent, which is highly preferable and mostly used in the industries to carry out the solvent extraction process. And So, at the same time, there is no substitute or there is no replacement for N-hexane commercially on cost basis. N-hexane. There is no substitute for N-hexane when we compare it with the help of with cost. Okay. So, from desolvatizing, steam is passed and solvent get mixed with this steam and change its phase. It get converted from liquid to vapor phase, and a mixture of vapor and solvent is sent for the distillation. In this way, in desolvatizing section, a maximum amount of solvent is get recovered and recycled. Okay. Now toasting operation. A series of heaters are provided, and a specific type of natural or required environment is obtained from toasting operation. In toasting operation, generally, toasting operation is carried out by with the help of heating trays. After this desolvatizing section, the solid phase material passes through the series of steam jacketed heating trays. The solid flash is passes after desolvatizing. It is passes through the steam jacketed heating plates, and which provides the required environment for the toasting operation. So toasting operation is also carried out here. After toasting, now we just focus on this desolvatizing and toasting operation, because this specific unit operation consume maximum amount of energy of your complete solvent extraction process. When we talk about this complete solvent extraction process or the complete flow sheet, only this specific section, desolvatizing and toasting, consumes lot of amount of energy, and it requires directly a high pressurized and high temperature pressure steam purged into the desolvatizing and toasting section, and it get directly contacted with your flesh or with your white flakes. So this is not a proper design to save the energy. This is the oldest method, we can say that, and there is a large amount of energy is required, and at the same time, from this section you recovered maximum amount of solvent, and at the same time you can able to recycle the same amount of solvent to the distillation unit. So that's why this is desolvatizing and toasting section is very important. Further few developments are carried out on this desolvatizing section to make it more economical, make it proper design, and increase the efficiency of your operation. And at the same time, when we talk about the new technologies, it minimizes the amount of steam required, the amount of steam consumed or required to carry out this operation, and it provides a greater counter current contact between steam and your white flesh, between steam and your extracted mill. Okay, then next point about our desolvatizing and toasting is pre-desolvatizing steam heated surfaces is provided before entering to desolvatizing section. Somewhat here, preheated plates are provided. If you want to make it operation more economical and proper, so preheated plates are provided before entering to desolvatizing section. With the help of this pre-desolvatizing steam heated surfaces, it is prior to desolvatizing inlet, and it is fitted just before the inlet of desolvatizing section, and inlet as an inexpensive way we are able to improve the ratio of specific dry heat to purge steam. Dry heat to purge steam ratio is increased. So with the help of this ratio, there is a requirement of minimum steam to vaporize the solvent. That is the actual process carried out here, vaporization of solvent, which is necessary to recycle to separate out the solvent from our oil mill. So with the help of this ratio, dry heat and purge steam, it is minimum, and it will and it will make your operation more economical and easier. Now with the help of this old or traditional desolventizing and toasting process, we are able to get, we are able to obtain the oil mill or extracted oil mill, which contains around moisture of 18% and temperature of this mill is around 90 to 110 or 105 degree Celsius or 105 degree Celsius. So the moisture content of your mill is very high, at the same time temperature of your mill is very high. So there is a necessity to proceed it with different operations, because the moisture content is very high and temperature is very high. With this moisture content and temperature, no one is able to sizing it. No one is able to directly sizing, grinding, or go for packaging and transportation. So there is a necessity to remove the moisture. So in simple words, removal of moisture, drying is necessary, and another, to reduce the temperature, cooling operation is necessary. That's why these two operations are extra, drying and cooling. So with the help of drying, moisture is get removed and set up to the some standard or optimum level of your oil cake, and by sending your oil mill to a slow rotating steam jacketed slow rotating steam tube dryers. With the help of these devices or with the help of forced aeration, we are able to dry your oil mill. We are able to dry the flesh and to reduce the moisture to a proper storage level. After the drying is accomplished, you need to cool it, because the temperature is still more. So that's why your extracted mill is sent for the cooling operation, and to carry out this cooling operation or removal of this excessive heat, it is sent for the rotary cleaners. With the help of rotary clean, where a cooling occur by a indirect contact of your oil mill with the help of with a cooling water, or your oil mill is directly exposed to the larger circulation of your large amount of air. So in this way your drying and cooling is also carried out. So this is the another important unit operation or unit of your solvent extraction process, drying and cooling. Because if drying and cooling is not carried out in a proper way, then your byproduct, oil mill or oil cake, is not useful, or you are not getting the proper quality of your product. So drying and cooling is also important. This one is first very important, this is second very important. So for the economic purpose and some recent developments, we are integrated these two operations. Initially, we are integrated these two operations, that is desolventizing and toasting, in a one sector, integrated one. And finally, we are able to integrate these two operations also, that is drying and cooling also. Now, when we integrate drying and cooling, it is carried out in a vertical type vessel. Oil mill is present here, and some thermic fluid is provided to carry out the drying. At the same time, cooling is also carried out with the help of circulation of some chilling or cooling material. So with the help of this vessel, a vertical type vessel, both drying and cooling operation is carried out, and you get the product. Okay. Now, if we focus on these flow sheet, the main operation is DT and DC. This is integrated one, this is integrated two. DST is desolventizing toasting, and DC is drying and cooling. So in further development, we are easily integrated all these four operations into one form, which is known as DTDC, desolventizing, toasting, drying and cooling in a single unit. Due to this we are able to reduce the space, we are able to manage it with it provides some advantages. The first advantage of this is less space is required. It reduces the initial investment, capital cost is less required. Then side by side, it also provides us less energy required. Energy required is less, and there is a cost cutting. So these are the four different advantages when you integrated these all four operations at a single vessel. In a single vessel or in a single operation, if we are able to manage with the help of recent heat exchangers, thermic fluid, recent designing in chemical engineering, by using all these types of recent advanced skills, we are able to get these advantages. It reduces the space required. Initial capital cost required for this setup is less. Then energy required, steam consumption is less, and at the same time, with all these advantages, cost cutting is also there. So these are the few advantages of this process. Now finally we again focus on the DTDC just for 1 or 2 minutes. When we actually focus on all four operations, then this is all about your mostly about your temperature. With the help of good heat exchangers and thermic fluid, you are able to manage all, because in some operations you need to drop down the temperature, in some operations you need to increase the temperature. If you are able to manage the proper flow of your thermic fluids, definitely the energy of another compound or the energy of initial temperature is useful, or the first product is raw material for the second one. How? Because here is a continuous requirement of heating and cooling. First thing, temperature, first parameter. Second thing means, if there is a high temperature of your raw material, with the help of this, if your raw material is sent in a heat exchanger, you can send a cool thermic fluid. So heat exchanger is there and your thermic fluid become hotter. If your thermic temperature of your thermic fluid is increased, at the same time, if you need to provide heat anywhere inside your complete solvent extraction process, this thermic fluid is useful. Similarly, in the cooling manner, you using cooling water to cool your cake. So when water and cake comes in contact with each other, so there is a exchange of heat is there. So cooling water get increased and cake will become decreased. Again, this cooling water will be circulated where if there is a necessity of any heating operation. So in this way, you can make your operation economical with the help of proper circulation and design. Temperature. My second one is moisture. There is a requirement of during desolventizing, you need to remove the solvents. During drying, you need to remove the moisture or water. Again, this concentration is useful somewhere, you need to recycle or reuse it. Okay, now finally finally we will move on. This is all about the bottom of this brochure, already explained. DTDC is completely covered. Okay, now let's move on this micellar refining. Here some impurities are get refined with the help of evaporators. So from this first evaporator, the quality of oil or the concentration of oil is around only 28% to 80% for first pass of your evaporator. If you are okay with this type of quality of crude oil, then it directly sent for your refining, first stage of refining. Otherwise, you go for the second stage of evaporator. And with this second stage of evaporator, around I think 95% to 98% of oil, 95% to 98% of oil purity is obtained. If again you are not happy or you are not getting the required parameters or quality or purity of oil, then again it will send for the third evaporator and again it will increase the, your concentration of your oil. So till evaporator second, the refining is carried out and around 95% to 98% of refined oil is get sent to the sent for further operation as a crude oil, and this crude oil is now ready to send for the refining stages. Okay. At the same time, oil leaving the solvent extraction unit or solvent extraction process, that is crude oil, is must containing a moisture and volatile component below 0.15%. This is also the one requirement before going for the refining or first stage of refining. Before send it for the refining section, the crude oil must contain 0.15% or below 1.5% of moisture and volatile component. Okay, I think every parameter related to the solvent extraction process, specifically related to the edible section, edible oil processing, is already carried out. So today I will stop here, and next few lectures or next few videos I will make on first thing numericals. I will make numericals of, there are two topics to make the numericals. I will post individual videos for both the numericals. First one is on drying of anything, drying of oil cake, drying of oil sets, removal of solvent from oil cake. There are n number of possibilities with drying operation. Second thing is about leaching. Leaching means your solid liquid extraction, which is carried out here actually. Solid liquid extraction. Okay. How the oil will be extracted from solid phase, a liquid oil is extracted with the help of solvent. This is known as leaching operation. And all the industrial parameters and operating conditions, what are the various values, it will be covered in our numerical. So today I will stop here. Thank you so much.